Well, welcome to Lohre Farm, everybody. Today, Van and I are here. We're going to teach you how to make a simple, easy microbial solution to get your planter boxes and your garden started off just right. Some things that we're going to need: you're going to want a 5-gallon bucket filled with about 4 gallons of water. You're going to want that from a well or rainwater. You really don't want to use chlorinated city water. If you live in the city and that's all you have, what I would suggest is fill the bucket with 4 gallons of water, let it sit out overnight about 24 hours to dechlorinate and start your process the next day. Some other things that you're gonna need: some cooked potatoes. We're gonna need sea salt, roughly 15 grams. We're gonna need to gather a small stick that can go across the top of the bucket. We're gonna wanna get some zip ties. You're gonna also wanna get some cheesecloth. You can use an old sock if you want to, preferably no holes in the sock or dirty, but you can use an old sock. What you're gonna wanna gather is some leaf mold or mycelium that I'm sure you can find somewhere on your property. I'm sure somewhere you have a pile of leaves that have been there since fall. And if you look underneath, you'll notice that white powdery, or in the case of mycelium, it kind of looks stringy, almost like spider webby. All right, now that we've gathered up all of our materials, what's the first thing that we're gonna add, Van?
We're gonna add the salt.
Yeah, we're gonna add the salt. We wanna put some minerals back into that water. A lot of water is lacking minerals, and the salt will help. Now the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna get our potatoes ready. Now the potatoes are gonna be for the starch. That's what the mycelium and the leaf mold is gonna start to feed on when it's inside of the bucket. Put them inside of this sack. Now you can use cheesecloth or, like I said, an old sock or something like that to put them in. But basically you just wanna take your cooked potatoes. Usually for about 4 gallons, it takes 2 to 3 potatoes based on size. These ones are about medium-sized potatoes, so we're gonna go with 3. Put a zip tie on the top so that nothing can fall out. Then you're gonna wanna take your handy stick, and you're gonna wanna hang this from the stick inside of, draping down into the water. In the other sack, you're gonna wanna put in your mycelium and all of your leaf mold dirt. And then you're going to want to hang that into the bucket just like you did the potatoes. Now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to start to massage and mash the potatoes with your hands in the water. You can start to see all that starch filling in the water and clouding it up. You're going to want to do the same thing with the bag of the mycelium and leaf mold. Just massage that with your hands and start letting that get into the water a little bit. And it's gonna start turning the water a little bit brown. Now that we got everything in the bucket, we wanna cover this with a plastic bag. I would suggest not using one of those scented kitchen bags. Just try to find a generic plastic bag to cover. You're going to want to let this sit for probably the next 2, maybe 3 days, depending on the ambient temperature. You really should have this at 70, 80 degrees, somewhere in there. You get down into the 60s or lower, it's going to take a little bit more time. What you're going to start to notice is as the leaf mold and the mycelium start to interact with the starch and it starts to feed off of it, you're gonna start to see some bubbling action take place, and then you know things are kind of starting to work. After 24 or 48 hours, everything's really starting to activate. You're seeing a lot of bubbles. That's about the time when you wanna use this. Now you're gonna wanna dilute it out. It's a 1:20 ratio. So what we end up doing here, because we use so much of it, is I use a stock tank. So what I'll do is I'll take this 4 gallons and I'll pour that into our stock tank, and then I'll start adding water until I get to that 1:20 ratio. From there, I can go around the farm and I can kind of use it as we need it. I usually don't like to keep it around more than a day or so. These microbes are ready to go into the soil. You want to do a nice soil drench on this.